Good evening, everyone. Coming to you live here from Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School from Kaohsiung, Taiwan. It is going to be another offering of your Asean Basketball League. Tonight, the home team, the Kaohsiung Truth, will in a must-win situation right now against the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. Good evening once again, everyone. As you guys can see, the game on our hands today. My name is Martin Javier alongside Marco Benitez today. Now, Marco, it is going to be a great matchup today. A lot of pressure for the Kaohsiung Truth to come up with a victory tonight against the mighty Hong Kong team.
And yes, good evening to everybody watching us. And like you said, Martin, this is going to be a big must-win game here for the Kaohsiung Truth. They are coming off a loss or three straight losses, back-to-back losses for them. Last one against the same team, Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, way back in February 22, back in Hong Kong. Meanwhile, it is a bigger game for them, especially after the outcome of the Saigon Heat victory over the Singapore Slingers, because with that win, Saigon moves up to 6-9 right now, solo fourth spot. Kaohsiung right now at 5-10 right now, looking outside into that final four. So they're going to need that victory, especially with four more games after this one. So let's see what they have in store for us tonight.
Let's talk about that first, Marco. The remaining games for the three bottom teams in the ABL right now, for Saigon, Westport's Malaysia Dragons, and of course the home team right now, the Kaohsiung Truth. What do they have to overcome for them to obtain that fourth and final spot?
Well, five more games for Kaohsiung Truth, including this one. After this game, they're going to face the Singapore Slingers, the Westport's Malaysia Dragons, two games against the Dragons, and then they're going to close out their elimination round with the Alap Pilipinas. For the Saigon Heat, the other team they are closely competing with for that fourth and final spot. After that victory against the Slingers, they will face the Dragons, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, two more games against the Slingers, and one more game after Hong Kong. So that's one against the Dragons, two against the Hong Kong Long Lions, and then two against the Singapore Slingers, while the Westport's Malaysia Dragons will be facing Alap Pilipinas today, the Saigon Heat, and they will have two more games against the Kaohsiung Truth. So in terms of schedule, it might look a little tougher for the Saigon Heat, and quote-unquote easier schedule would fall under the laps of the Kaohsiung Truth and possibly the Westport's Malaysia Dragons, although the Dragons still with just three victories to their name.
So that is the situation right now for the bottom three teams in the league. Who can obtain or who will obtain the fourth spot? We'll find out at the end of the elimination round, but we are at the home stretch of the season. As you guys hear the introduction of the lineup of the Kaohsiung Truth, I think they're also going to do a quick ceremony honoring Holly Sue, who will be going back to the States in a few days.
We all know Holly Sue is the wife of team owner Wesley Sue, and has been supporting this squad 110% ever since the start of the season. And Martin, four of their five victories, talking about the Kaohsiung Truth, have come in this building. So there is such a thing as home court advantage for the Kaohsiung Truth, and they are going to rely heavily on that against the number one team, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions.
And can we not forget that just a couple of games ago, they were able to upset, of course, the Singapore Slingers here in their home floor. So they do have that capability of beating good teams, especially the contenders here in the season.
They're going to have to come up with a supreme effort here, especially after their lopsided loss against this Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions squad back in February 22. And as they close out the season, four more games after this one, I feel the magic number for that fourth and final spot in the final four will be about seven or eight victories. Kaohsiung right now at 5-10. Saigon at 6-9. Westport's Malaysia Dragons at 3-13.
Let's leave the conversation there first, and let's go to the formalities of this game.
Thank you.
All right, here we go. Let's talk about first. All right, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. Marco, the Long Lions, they're a very strong team. Let's talk about first, the seven-game winning streak that they are now in coming into tonight's game.
Well, they've been very impressive here. One of the expansion teams here in the ABL this season, and together with the Kaohsiung Truth, they've been taking this league by storm. Only two defeats this entire season, both at the hands of the Singapore Slingers. They've added Josh Boone to their lineup for the last three games. He's been with them for the past three games. And before, we thought that it would be a bit of a concern,
yes,
for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions because of the adjustment they would have to make. Patrick Sullivan had been a good world import for them, but so far, Josh Boone has just upgraded their lineup and have upgraded their game, has provided a lot of the defensive presence and the rebounding presence that they lacked in their initial games here, and has made the game a lot more easier for guys like Marcus Elliott, even Tyler Lambert. It has been their shooting and their defense and their overall talent that has taken this league by storm.
But of course, another key category here in this game, in today's game, for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions would be the three-point shooting of this team. Remember, the last time these two teams played in Southern Stadium in Wan Chai, Hong Kong, they had 17 three-pointers in that particular game as a team.
That is correct, and they set an ABL record for number of three-pointers by a team at 17. And this is a team that shoots about 36% from the three-point area, 44.8%. As you take a look at the ceremony happening on the floor, that is Holly Sue in the maroon shirt, and she is leaving Kaohsiung, heading back to the States for a trip, and might miss their last few games of the elimination round. But should they make it to the Final Four, you can be sure that she'll be back here to support the squad.
Of course, Holly, the number one fan, of course, of the Kaohsiung Truth this season. Just the energizer of this particular team. Probably one of the reasons why they do so well here at home.
And we've been talking to her for several times before and after games. Really a kind-hearted person. She brings her kids to the games. And really all-out support here. As you can see, the squad, each of them giving flowers to Holly Sue. Very touching ceremony here by the Kaohsiung Truth.
Such a nice gesture here for the Kaohsiung Truth. Before the game, they're just honoring Holly Sue before he goes back, or she goes back to the United States. Of course, the last guy at the back, of course, her husband, Wesley Sue.
And you know, Wesley Sue looking for bit of inspiration here against the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. He's been in a slump lately. The terrific outside shooting at the start of the tournament, he was shooting at about 50% from the three-point area, but defenses have adjusted to that outside shooting and have put a lot of emphasis every time he catches the ball and gets ready to take that three-point shot. So his shooting percentage, especially from deep, has dropped significantly, and his scoring has also dropped. Hopefully, he'll be able to turn things around here on this momentous occasion.
There you go, the Kaohsiung Truth honoring again Holly Sue. And Holly Sue, of course, wearing the jersey of Wesley Sue. She has a message to all of the fans here. There you go, Holly Sue. Send-off ceremony before the start of this game. But let's shift our attentions to the Kaohsiung Truth as we take a look at first our starting lineups for both teams. For Hong Kong, Chan Siu Wing, Marcus Elliott, Tyler Lam, Tang Chi Hang in for the injured Fong Xingyi. Of course, Josh Boone in the middle at the center position for the Long Lions.
And that is a potent lineup, even without Fong Xingwei starting for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. They still have Marcus Elliott, Tyler Lamb, and Josh Bulumima for the Kaohsiung Truth. You have Achi Inigo starting for them, Cedric Oliver, Wesley Su, Derek Hall, Shang, their lefty shooter, also starting in place of Jay Wei. So looking to add more of an outside threat here. We know that the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, the number one three-point shooting team in the league. They're also one of the best defensive teams.
Yes.
They force 10.8 steals. Or they get 10.8 steals per game, force about 20 turnovers per outing. And the second best team in terms of forcing turnovers forces about 11 turnovers. So you see the big disparity in terms of the number of turnovers forced by the Long Lions against the rest of the league.
That's how good Hong Kong has been here in the season. But for the Kaohsiung Truth, Marco, it is going to be Derek Hall, Mr. Consistent for them. He needs to come up with a big game against the number one team in the league.
That is correct, Derek Hall. They're walking double-double. Averages about 20.4 points per game. Shoots at an amazing 52% clip from the three-point area. 12.3 rebounds, 3.1 assists per game. What you like about Derek Hall, very consistent. He likes to play on the outside, but he also has that back-to-the-basket game. Loves to shoot that baby hook shot. And he's a great passer for a seven-footer. He's able to find Cedric Oliver on the corners. They like to run that high-low play between Derek Hall and Raymar Jose whenever Raymar Jose comes off the bench, especially against a small forward of opposing teams. So a very integral part of this Kaohsiung Truth team is Derek Hall.
And of course, it's going to be interesting to see if the Kaohsiung Truth will continue to play that 2-3 zone they've been playing for the past few games. They lost two games in a row, so I don't know if things are going to change for Coach Sabatino Chen and the Kaohsiung Truth.
That 2-3 zone once again out this ball game. That's going to be a traveling violation for Tyler Lamb. I think that 2-3 zone has worked against a lot of their opponents, but against the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, if they decide to stick with that 2-3 zone, they're going to have to be a lot more active, especially on the perimeter. We know that Hong Kong is a perimeter-oriented team. They like to initiate their offense coming off that ball screen from the wing. So they're going to have to pressure that ball screen and force the ball out of the hands of Marcus Elliott or Tyler Lamb.
But the game is now underway. Kaohsiung Truth looking to score a victory over the visiting team, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. Here's a steal for the Truth. Inigo on the other end for the easy lay-in.
And that's going to be a big bonus for them. Points off third overs. If they can get those here, they're going to be able to keep in step with Hong Kong. We know that is Hong Kong's calling card.
Here comes Hong Kong again. Fong Xingyi not in the starting lineup for them with a hand injury. Marcus Elliott. Corner three, that's no good, or offensive board.
And that's a missed block out there for Cedric Oliver. He's the one manning that bottom corner, that 2-3. So he's the one in charge of the box out as Marcus Elliott starts them off with that three-pointer at the top of the key.
That puts them up by one. 3-2 is our score early here in the first quarter.
Marcus Elliott, one of the leading candidates for MVP for World Import, shoots at a high 44% from the three-point area.
As we take a look at that steal, that fast break play, Achi Inigo finishing on the other end.
It's going to be a tough matchup here for Achi Inigo against Elliott.
Oliver. Oh, mid-range jumper is good. Cedric Oliver.
And that's also a matchup problem here for Coach Edu Torres. Cedric Oliver against a smaller hand.
Chan Su wing. They swing the ball around. Back to wing. Oh, miscommunication. Oliver was able to track down that ball. Here we go.
That's going to be another turnover for the Eastern Long Lions.
Inigo penetrating. He goes to Oliver inside. Triple teamed. Kicks it back out. Derek Hall for the jumper. No good. Elliott with the rebound.
Yes, this is what Hong Kong likes to do. Every off a miss or turnover, they're always looking to run in transition.
Here's Lam for three. Not short. But again, they come up with the offensive board. Elliott for three. That's also no good for Marcus Elliott. Tyler Lam somehow finishes. for the Long Lions.
And you know, Hong Kong not really known as one of the better rebounding teams. They only average about 37 rebounds per game, which is actually last in the league. As Kaohsiung is a better rebounding team statistically, but right now Hong Kong dominating the boards.
But here we go on the other end. Derek Hall is scoring on that second attempt.
Good tap there from Chang, tapping the ball out of the hands of Marcus Elliott.
Chansey Wing, corner pressure, and that leads to another turnover for Hong Kong.
And that is going to be the third turnover here for the Long Lions. Very uncharacteristic. Here's a rebound of Tyler Lam over the back of Wesley Su.
Too athletic. Tyler Lam just towering over Wesley Su. The Truth now up by one, 6-5, 6:40 to go here in the first. Wesley Su, he needs to get going. That's a good sign for Su, nailing his first three-pointer.
Talking about inspirations there, that's a good sign. As you said, Martin, hasn't hit a three-pointer in a long while against the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions.
They move the ball around. Tang for three, no good. Oh, they scrambled for the ball.
Great ball movement, I was about to say, for the Eastern Long Lions from right to left.
Here's that play one more time. Wesley Su shooting over Chansu Wing. Boone, oh, nice pass inside, and Tang finishes underneath.
A lot of good movement without the ball here for the Long Lions, and that is the problem with a 2-3 zone. Once they start collapsing on a big guy inside the paint, baseline is usually open for the cutter.
And a traveling violation right there for Cedric Oliver. Here's that great ball movement. Josh Boone with the extra pass to the cutting Tang Chi Hang.
And you know, Josh Boone has been a great addition for this Eastern Long Lions squad. He's averaging 23.7 points and 12.7 rebounds per game.
Here's Josh Boone scoring his first 2 points off the game. Right on cue, Marco.
Yep. He has been a great inside presence. And you know, since the entry of Josh Boone, Marcus Elliott's assist numbers have improved from 5.4 per game. Right now he's averaging 8 assists per ball game. A lot of those courtesy of Josh Boone.
Chang Hao Chun, too strong on that three. Here's Elliott in transition. Derek Hall, nice hustle. Tapping it from behind. Chang looking for a teammate. Oh, but Wing, he was able to deflect that pass. Tyler Lam, in transition, alley-oop to Marcus Elliott.
Coming out of nowhere right there. Great eye contact. And the familiarity and athleticism of these two players just off the charts.
We were clearly not prepared for that, Marco, as Wesley Su misfires again. We have another timeout on the floor. I think this one's for Coach Sabatino Chen and the Kaohsiung Truth. We'll be back for more of your ASEAN Basketball League action.
Stop is the gas station. I like to call it the ass station. I always see girls pumping it up. I stumble on up. I say what's up and ask questions. Excuse me, what you doing tonight? I got a party at my crib. I'm picking you to invite. Woo. She got a booty that's out the frame. I nicknamed it High Octane. I made her laugh, told her some motor dash, and in a flash walked away with the math. Next stop, Whole Foods. Me and the crew, we call it Whole Foods. It be cracking on the weekend. The only place you could find a big booty on a vegan. Her name was Shelly. Tattoos and a ring on her belly.
Okay, 现场的朋友，目前呢，我们出战呢，香港的东方呢。
Back here again in the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School as we take a look at that monster throwdown, first by Marcus Elliott, the alley-oop from Tyler Lam, Marco, this early in the game.
That just shows you the athleticism and the elevation of Marcus Elliott coming from the baseline. Another Ooh. Turnover here, but counter turnover here for the Kaohsiung Truth. And this is one of the stronger lineups and more athletic lineups here of Hong Kong. They have Stephen Ginchard playing the four spot. So this is a quick lineup with Josh Boone at the five. Jay Wei also in for the Kaohsiung Truth.
Changhao Chun now sits on the bench for the Truth. Elliott, top of the key three. That's good for Marcus Elliott.
And that's just too easy, Martin. Off the ball screen, Jaywei has to come up because Achi Inigo is being screened by Josh Boone. So nobody there to challenge the outside shot of Marcus Elliott.
It is now five, biggest off the game so far. 14-9 for the visiting team. Hall looks to answer, or looking to answer, and Derek Hall does just that.
That's a great pass there from Cedric Oliver. That shot is going to force Josh Boone to stay honest on defense and not allow him to double-team Cedric Oliver in the paint.
Tyler Lam, they swing the ball around. Ginchard, corner three. That's strong.
And you know, that's okay. As long as it's not Marcus Elliott or Tyler Lam connecting on those threes, you force somebody else to beat you on offense.
Here's Inigo trying to go inside. Floater is no good. Here comes the Long Lions. Tyler Lam. They swing the ball around. Elliott on the other side for three. That's good. Two three-pointers right now here in the first quarter for Marcus Elliott.
And that's just great patience on offense. Tyler Lam did not have a shot. Pass it to wing. Look for an open man. They found Marcus Elliott on the left wing. Easy three-point shot.
Lead is back up to five here with 3 minutes to go here in the first. Cedric Oliver. Great matchup inside against Ginchard, but Cedric Oliver just too strong and scores that 2 points.
They can take advantage of Cedric Oliver, a lot taller than Stephen Ginchard.
Here's Lam. No good on the three. Oliver with a rebound. Jay Wei. Ooh. I was about to say it, I was in advice, but he made it anyway.
Never a bad shot when it goes in. Jaywei ties the ball game up at 17. So good job here by the Kaohsiung Truth, keeping in step with Hong Kong.
Elliott, oh, just forces that one up, but it goes in anyway for Marcus Elliott.
No help defense there to draw the charge on the driving Marcus Elliott.
Here's Sue, back to Derek Hall outside. Hall takes it in, off the glass, no good. Boone with a rebound. Long Lions in transition, Tyler Lam. No good with a left hand. Oliver on the other end, looking for his teammates. Wesley Sue, top of the key three. Short.
That's a quick shot there from Wesley Sue. Nobody there to rebound. One and done on that possession, or on the past three possessions for the Kaohsiung Truth.
Here's Wing looking for Josh Boone inside. But Josh Boone misfires. Tyler Lam draws a foul on the second attempt. That will be against Cedric Oliver.
And you know what we love about the perimeter players of Hong Kong as we take a look at this pull-up three-point shot from Jay Wei that ties the ball game up. What you love about the perimeter players of Hong Kong is they love to crash boards even from the outside. There's that post-up play against Stephen Ginchard.
Tyler Lam right now at the free throw line. He's been doing well for the Long Lions here in the season, providing them a third option in scoring. Yep. And of course, their number one option in terms of defense.
He's averaging about 3.2 steals per game. I believe he's one of the top three in the ABL, also scoring 17.2 points per game, 6.2 rebounds per game. And here is that patented 1-2-2 full court pressure from the Long Lions.
But the Truth were able to break it through Sluo. Almost deflected and intercepted for the Long Lions. Jay Wei for three. No good. Lam with a board.
No second chance opportunities for the truth.
Last 1 minute here in the first. That's a turnover.
And you know, Martin, without Marcus Elliott and without Josh Boone on the floor, this is a good opportunity for the truth to try to stem this or try to close this gap and possibly even take the lead.
Still a 4-point lead for the Long Lions here. Kaohsiung Truth doing just enough to keep them in step and keep them in the game. And speaking of Jay Way, another 3-point bomb.
That's a good shot there for Jay Way. Raymar says also checked into the ball game.
1-point lead for the Long Lions. Here's Wing Lee from the outside. Oh, nice steal from Luo. He is in transition, but Ginchard is right there to intercept that pass. 13 seconds here in the first. Lee. Tyler Lam looking to slow this pace down. Oh, Lam, nice pass inside to Stephen Ginchard.
That's just a great move there from Tyler Lam. And at the last second, finding an open Stephen Ginchard.
And that extends the lead to 3 points, but still great effort from both teams. Kaohsiung Truth able to keep in step with the Long Lions here in the first quarter, but the Long Lions are still... Kaohsiung, Taiwan for this game between the Kaohsiung Truth and the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. The Hong Kong Eastern Lions, Eastern Long Lions are in the lead right now, 23-20. But despite that, Marco, it was a great effort for the Kaohsiung Truth to keep in step of the number one team in the league.
And you know, the reason why the Truth are in this ball game is because of the three-point shooting. They're shooting 50% from the three-point there. And they've also capitalized on the turnovers of the Long Lions. They've scored 8 points off of the Long Lions' turnovers.
Shin is also in the ball game for the Truth.
Still no Marcus Elliott and Josh Boone for Hong Kong.
More minutes for the local players here for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions.
And you know, this could be possibly because Hong Kong just played last Friday against the Westports Malaysia Dragons, and with them almost assured of first or second spot or that twice to beat advantage, Coach Edu Torres possibly resting, giving his main guns a little more rest than usual and allowing the local players more exposure, especially because he might need his second and third stringers come the semifinals.
Kaohsiung Truth going with Shin, Derek Hall, Raymar Jose, Jay Way, and Cedric Oliver to start the second quarter. As for the Long Lions, Wu Chuk Pan, Chan Siu Wing, Lee Ki, and Tyler Lam, with Steven Ginchard also on the floor for the Long Lions, as Derek Hall goes to the free throw line.
Meanwhile, that was a great baseline inbounds play off the screen for Cedric Oliver. Derek Hall immediately rolling to the basket, and Cedric Oliver obliging him with that dump down pass. No rest here so far for Derek Hall and Cedric Oliver.
Well, they know the gravity of this game with, again, the Saigon Heat winning earlier.
Yep. Lau Chu Lai and Marcos Elliott checking into the ball game. First appearance here for Lau Chu Lai.
The lead is down to 122-23. Here's that ball movement for the Long Lions again. Elliott, Chu Lai for three. No good, Jose with that board.
And talk about points in the first quarter. Marcus Elliott leading all scorers with 13 points in that opening quarter. So good sign for him. Remember, in their last outing, he had just 2 points in the first half. Finished with 11 in that ball game. As that's a great block from Marcus Elliott over Raymar Jose.
That also forces the travel on Raymar Jose as we go the other way here. 4-point lead for the Long Lions with under a minute gone here in the second quarter.
Full court pickup for Jay Way against Marcos Elliott. Now they drop to a 2-3 zone.
Elliott penetrating, forces one up. Hall with a board. And Lau commits that foul on Shin.
And, you know, very significant dip in terms of rebounding and inside presence for the Long Lions while when Boone is off the floor.
Josh Boone, of course, only has 4 points here in this ballgame, yep, which is very unusual for the big man of the Long Lions. But Cedric Oliver just powering his way inside.
And Coach Edu Torres immediately sending Boone back to the scorer's table. He's going to check in on the next dead ball.
Lee Key wanted to take a three, but that pass is too high for Wu Chuk Pan. There's another substitution for the Kaohsiung Truth. Jay Wei will sit. Shang Ao Chun back on the floor.
So that was about 4 minute rest for Josh Boone. And they were able to keep that or prevent Kaohsiung from taking a big enough lead, just up by one, are the Truth.
Here's Chang, sees a wide open Derek Hall. Elliott against Chang. Elliott with a crossover. Marcus Elliott! What a move! Just too strong for the Long Lions.
Just a great hesitation move there for Marcus Elliott, making like he was going to pass to Josh Boone, but then finishing with the right hand.
Here's that move one more time for Marcus Elliott. Crossover and just hangs, and I don't know what to call it, Margo.
I think he was decided to pass it to Josh Boone, but Derek Hall did not bite the fake, so ended up taking it instead.
Freakish athleticism, of course, from Marcus Elliott. Here they are in transition. Ginchard with an easy lay-in on the other end.
And that is the luxury of having Josh Boone, even though he's the one in front of the fast break with enough presence of mind to find the open man in Steven Ginchard.
Here's Chang, forces one up, and Oliver with a tip.
A little more active on the offensive glass is Cedric Oliver, getting his first putback.
Back down to a 1-point lead for the Long Lions with 7 minutes to go here in the first half. Josh Boone in the middle. Ginchard for three. Too strong. Ball will go back to the Kaohsiung Truth.
And even though that was a miss, Martin, you love the spacing of the Long Lions. Four players outside the paint or outside the three-point area. Just Josh Boone inside the paint. As Achi Inigo checks back into the ball game.
Hong Kong is still applying that full court press.
And this is where they force a lot of turnovers averaging about 20 turnovers forced.
Here's Inigo looking for Jose inside. Off the glass is no good for Raymar Jose.
Sorry, miss there for Raymar Jose. And they were looking for Marcos Elliott on the break. They actually had that long outlet pass, but Ao Chu Lai was not able to field it. So was Ki Lee.
As we see that hustle from Chang Ao Chu and Lee Ki. Here's Josh Boone, corner three. Ao Chu Lai drains that three-pointer.
And the supporting cast of Coach Edu Torres contributing here.
Lead is up to 7 points, or 4 points rather, for the Long Lions.
Now it's Hong Kong's turn to drop to that zone.
Chang having difficulties against Lau. Here's Chang wide open. Oh! But Lee Ki forces that steal. And here he is in transition all the way for that layup, Lee Ki.
That forces a timeout here for Coach Sabatino Chen. 2-on-1 fast break there.
Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions still up here over the Kaohsiung Truth. We'll be back. We are back here in fans of the Kaohsiung Truth here in Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School, watching of course the home team take on the number one team in the league, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. But right now it's the visiting team who are up by 6 points, 32-26, halfway here in the second quarter.
Family affair here on a Sunday. Good sized crowd here. That's going to be another turnover for the Truth.
Lee Ki forcing another steal and draws a foul on the other end. That will be against Lee Wee Min.
And you probably don't want Lee as the back pass or that safety pass against that 1-2-2 full court press. You'd probably want Cedric Oliver there instead of Lee Ki, or sorry, instead of Lee, because he has the better ball handling skills and he can make that pass over the defender.
Lee Ki, tremendous defender coming off the bench for Coach Edu Torres. He makes both free throws. Lead is now up to 8 points, I believe biggest in the game so far. Oliver.
Yeah, they make the adjustment there. You see Cedric Oliver as the release pass against that 1-2-2.
Here's Inigo adjusting. Chang to Oliver. He takes that shot in and out. Elliott in transition. Ooh! He was able to elude his defender. But it's a foul underneath for Chang Hao Chun.
Undercutting Marcos Elliott. And Marcos Elliott did not even take that shot because he was wary of the defender under him.
Very dangerous foul.
Yeah, very dangerous situation there for Marcos Elliott.
But he's all right. Very tough player, Marcos Elliott.
The referee calling it as a regular foul.
He misses the first.
I guess they decided there was no malicious intent there. on Chang's part to hurt Marcus Elliott. It's still a very awkward fall there for Elliott.
And that might have affected him because he missed both free throws. Chang now for three, too strong. Derek Hall with the offensive board. Finding Inigo, cutting.
And this is the problem for Kaohsiung. Once they start to miss from the outside, where will the offense come from? Especially with Josh Boone protecting the paint. They're going to have to try to find some cutters getting in or try to isolate Cedric Oliver in the post with Derek Hall at the top of the key.
Still an 8-point lead for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. 3 seconds on the shot clock. And Oliver forcing that one up. He needed to get that one up.
That is going to be turnover number 8 for the Kaohsiung Truth. Hong Kong has also 8 turnovers here in the first half.
4:40 to go here in the second quarter. Hong Kong still up by 8 points, 34-26. As Lau draws a foul. That will be against Chang once again.
Lau Chulai hesitated on that 3-point shot for a split second. Even looked like he took a couple of steps.
Jay Wei now back on the floor with Chang Hao Chun dealing with foul trouble here.
Tyler Lamb also checking back into the ball game for Lau Chulai.
As you saw, the very young coach of the Kaohsiung Truth, Coach Sabatino Chen. Here's Lee. Elliott faking that pass to Tyler Lamb, and he finds Josh Boone inside for the deuce.
That's just a great look there for Marcus Elliott, penetrating the defense, and then the underhanded scoop pass to Josh Boone.
And do not look now, it's a double-digit lead for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. Inigo, corner three, that's in and out.
That's another miss, and the percentage of Kaohsiung dropping significantly here from the outside.
Lee misfires also on the other end. Inigo in transition against Josh Boone. Sue open for three. Short. Inigo scrambling for that ball and coming up with the offensive board. Oliver looking for Derek Hall inside. Hall. Oh, bounce doesn't go for Derek Hall.
Field goals of Kaohsiung really suffering here in the second quarter. They're now down to about 38% from the field.
Here's Tyler Lamb. Oh, nice fake. Lamb with a floater. That rolls out. Inigo. A couple of misses from both teams.
Yep.
Asean enters the ball game here.
Here's that drive once again from Marcus Elliott and the underhanded pass beneath the arms of Derek Hall.
Marcus Elliott just forcing his way inside as you take a look at his numbers in tonight's game. 15 points already here in the first half. Oh, dangerous pass right there. Sue, corner three, too strong, still struggling. Derek Hall finding Oliver inside, posting up against Steven Ginchard. And he is able to draw a foul against Steven Ginchard.
That's a good decision there on the part of Derek Hall. Instead of taking that 15-footer, saw Cedric Oliver with a mismatch against Ginchard. And they were arguing whether that was a goaltending call as Josh Boone got a piece of that ball.
Josh Boone, you guys saw him fly in. Just altering that shot of Cedric Oliver. And Cedric Oliver missing both free throws.
6 points in the ball game for Cedric Oliver. Still has not hit a free throw here.
Here's Tyler Lamb. Back to Lamb. Back to Boone inside. And that's a foul on Wesley Su.
That's a great give and go play there between Tyler Lamb and Josh Boone in traffic. Here's that pass and the return pass to Boone, and Wesley Su was forced to foul.
Josh Boone, of course, we were talking about him at the top of the coverage, Marco. We thought that his entry at the middle of the season would be detrimental for the system of Coach Edu Torres, but so far, he's been doing well for the Long Lions.
He's averaging 23 points, 12 rebounds per game, and has really not really looked for his points. He scored within the flow of the system. As Cedric Oliver hits that baseline jumper, and talk about Josh Boone as another turnover here from Marcus Elliott.
Shin coming up with a steal, just intercepting that pass and getting into those passing lanes. Here's that jump shot earlier for Cedric Oliver. They badly need a big game from him tonight.
8th point of the ball game for Cedric Oliver.
Sue kicks it back out to Shin from way downtown. That one almost got in. Elliott pulls up. Oh, Marcus Elliott hits the tough shot over Wesley Sue.
And before that three-point shot, he was signaling for his teammates to come down in transition. But as everybody was covered, decides to take it on his own.
Here's that move one more time. Marcus Elliott just draining that three-pointer. Still an 11-point lead, 39-28 for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions as we lead to another timeout on the floor. We'll be back for more of your ASEAN Basketball League action.
Right into motion. They're probably gonna press. Okay, watch 1-2-2 press. Run into motion. Get it moving. Side to side. Screen. Attack. You stay on one side. It's not gonna work. Okay. Hey, four top guys. You gotta bump with each other. Stop dribble penetration. Be in the gap. Bump. Be in the gap.
Go. No, guys, we gotta get this.
Defense on three. 1-2-3.
We're back here in the ASEAN Basketball League. You guys just heard Coach Sabatino Chen give his instructions to his Kaohsiung Truth team. They are down right now by double digits, 39-28.
And Marty, with 2 minutes left here in the first half, they have to make a push here, cut this down to single digits. They don't want to go into the locker room down by double digits here as Hong Kong gaining momentum here in the first half.
Here's Sue. Oh, Josh Boone just flying in for that block.
And that is what you like about Josh Boone, even extending to the perimeter to be able to defend a three-point shot from Wesley Sue, who heads to the bench in favor of Raymar Jose.
Under 2 minutes left here in the first half. 11 seconds on the shot clock for the Truth. Here's Shin. Oliver defended well by Marcus Elliott. Here's Shin. Pop step. Jose puts it on the floor. And they don't realize that there were a few seconds remaining in the shot clock.
Raymar Jose probably should have taken that baseline jumper. And Coach Edu Torres wants to map out this offensive sequence, chance for them to go up by 13 or even 14 points to close out the first half.
Hey, we need to stop. Nice. Pass, cut. Look for your shot. Raymar, look for your shot. 5, 6, 8. Marcus, Tyler, you right side, you wing, Josh, right side. We pass or just dribble, all right? Two wing, quick, then skip. Instead of just a pass, you can dribble and you set Tyler free. Dribble and you set Tyler free. You understand? Okay? Then. Hey, then a good defense after, all right? Okay, let's go, come on.
One, two, three.
That was Coach Edu Torres of the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, a seasoned head coach. And he's been doing wonders this season for the Long Lions, putting them in first place in the standings right now.
Big stop here needed by the Kaohsiung Truth. I try to get a good stop going into that halftime locker room.
And they do just that. Raymar Jose sidesteps. Almost goes in, but Derek Hall is right there for the putback.
And you love the effort from Derek Hall, running down on offense in transition, gets that second chance opportunity, and the putback at the lead is back to single digits.
1:03 to go here in the first half. Marcus Elliott looking for Ginchen inside, but Josh Moon going strong for the jam.
Nobody there to box out Josh Boone as everybody was trying to recover on that lob pass for Steven Ginchard.
It is back to 11 points, 42 seconds to go here. Jose posting up Oliver Chang at the corner. Jay Wei, corner three, that's good! Jay Wei for three!
Big shot there for Jay Wei, but Hong Kong again in transition. Elliott decides to set it up.
About 4 seconds to separate the shot clock and the game clock here. Marcus Elliott gets the screen from Ginchard. Lam open for the corner three. That's good. Tyler Lam answers that three-pointer.
And you know that split-second shot fake by Wing makes all the difference for an open corner three by Tyler Lam.
As Raymar Jose beats the shot clock or the game clock, but his shot does not go in. The end of the first half, Marco. We find ourselves, or the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, are up now by 12 points after the Kaohsiung Truth made a great effort to keep them in the game in this first half.
Well, the three-point shooting of Kaohsiung deserted them in the second quarter, and that is the reason why Hong Kong was able to pull away, now in the lead by 12.
We'll be back for the halftime analysis here at the Asean Basketball. Thank you. Back here in the Asean Basketball League, as you guys can see, the highlights and the statistics of the first half. Marco, obviously, the Hong Kong Eastern Longlines with the upper hand here in our statistics.
And you know, the big difference in that second quarter was the three-point shooter, the Kaohsiung Truth, deserting them. They were shooting 50% from deep in the first quarter. Now it drops to 4 out of 16. They're shooting at about 33%. Sorry, they're shooting at about less than 30%. And that has really been the difference, as Hong Kong has continued to put pressure on the transition defense of the Kaohsiung Truth. And they've also dominated the boards, 21 to 15. Assists pretty much even. Steals also pretty much even. Kaohsiung has the upper hand in terms of turnovers, only with 8 turnovers compared to 13 by the Eastern Long Lions.
They were able to force a lot of turnovers, but they weren't able to take advantage of them. Talking about, of course, the Kaohsiung Truth, as we take a look at, of course, the leading scorer for the Kaohsiung Truth, Cedric Oliver, right now with 10 points, Derek Hall with 9, Jay Wei with 8, Wesley Su with that only three-pointer, or with this only three-pointer of this game.
And they're going to need a bigger effort here from both their world imports and their locals if they want to overhaul this 12-point deficit.
This is the intermission here in the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School. Let's take... we'll come back for more of your ASEAN Basketball League.
会打篮球吗？小时候打过。喜欢打。那今天呢，在我们场边呢，也来了一位特别来宾。那我们想说呢，是不是有这个机会呢，邀请呢Sam呢跟这位特别来宾呢来做一个表演赛好了，好不好？我来打吗？你打啊，当然。我打。对，我们欢迎呢，我们Sam请就发球线的位置。接着呢，我们用热情的掌声呢，欢迎进我们场边一位好朋友，欢迎高以翔来到活动现场。
跟他吗？他打很久了。他代表呢我们高雄的观众。那我代表谁啊？
你代表您自己。
我代表我自己。
等一下呢，如果呢你获胜的话，如果你获胜
，OK，
那我们就会送你一个纪念品。如果高以翔代表我们所有高雄的球迷朋友获胜，我们会送出20顶帽子给我们场边的朋友。现场的朋友，该帮谁加油？好
，OK。
来，球车推出来，球车，球车。我们会帮你捡球。
30秒的时间，30秒投篮的挑战赛，我们呢，对，你就一直投就可以了。来，球车拿过来，球车。 可以喽，哎，不好意思，小跑车可以把球借给我们吗？球车推过来，球车推出来，整台车推出来，一点国语吧，没关系，这有球，来，好，30秒的时间，我们来看看呢，我们会一直捡，会一直捡，不用担心，你不一定投得了那么多的。 好吧 ，Sam， 来准备喽，计时预备
，One two ready go，
丢回去。 哇塞！又会拉小提琴，又会打篮球。时间到，哎，不好意思，几颗啊？几个？六球，好。接下来呢，我们就要欢迎呢，掌声欢迎了我们高以翔。
最后一个，30秒，好。
然后计时预备
，One two ready go，
一分，两分。 时间到，那高以翔呢，一共投进了8分，管他了，我就是要把礼物送给大家就对了。那我们接下来呢，是不是请 Sam 跟那个高以翔把这个赠品呢赠送给了我们场边呢最热情的朋友，继续帮高雄加油的朋友在哪里？拍手。 再次感谢呢，我们高以翔，然后我们 Sam 呢来到我们活动现场，也当然呢，也希望大家持续呢帮呢我们高雄圣徒篮球队加油。 那我相信呢，如果呢长期以来呢一直支持呢我们高雄圣徒篮球队的球迷朋友，应该都知道，我们在每次呢赛后呢都会举办呢我们球员的拍照会，那以及握手会。 那我们今天呢也特别呢增加了两位呢可以来参与呢我们赛后的拍照跟握手的这个名额，那包括呢我们今天的小提琴家 Sam 以及呢我们高以翔，在赛后呢会跟我们高雄圣徒篮球队在场中央跟大家握手拍照，那也麻烦呢在赛后的时候呢可以呢踊跃的参与，并且呢遵从呢我们工作人员的引导，谢谢。当然最重要的是现场的朋友要大声的帮我们高雄圣徒篮球队加油，楼上的带动的大哥时间交给你了。
That was a 1-on-3 situation.
Coach Sabatino Chen starting with Axel Inigo, or Archie Inigo rather, Wesley Su, Chang Hao Chun, Derek Hall, and it's Cedric Oliver. It's Marcus Elliott right now at the free throw line. 12-point game, 44-32 in favor, of course, of the Long Lions.
Oh, and the referee calling a 5-second violation. That's the first time I've seen that here in the ABL.
I was about to mention that. We don't see it that often.
First time I've seen it here. So that free throw of Marcus said it does not count.
Second one is good for Marcus Elliott.
And here's that full court pressure once again.
Let's see if the Kaohsiung Truth can come back here in this game.
Look at Elliott's stats there. 19 points already for him.
19 points right now to start the third quarter.
And again, we were talking to start out the second half. The stakes are higher now for the Kaohsiung Truth. Right now, outside that final four spot at 5-10. Saigon Heat at 6-9. Four games remaining for the Truth. Five more for the Saigon Heat.
But a very tough task at hand as we see Tyler Lam draw a foul in transition. Very tough task to beat the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions even on your home floor, Marco.
Yep, and we talked about this earlier. Four of the five victories of Kaohsiung have come here in the, on their home floor. So they're very comfortable. They've been successful here. But right now, Hong Kong really stamping their class here, up by 14 points. And, you know, one of the big reasons why Hong Kong has played so well here in the tournament is because of their transition offense, always looking to run and put pressure on the defense, whether it's off a miss or off a turnover of the opposing team.
Just nonstop energy from the guys of head coach Edu Torres as we see Cedric Oliver nail that baseline jumper.
That is Cedric Oliver's 10 points, so he enters double digits.
12-point lead for the Long Lions. And the Long Lions missing that one. Oliver with the ball. looking for Wesley Su. Back to Oliver inside. Chang for three. Oh, and Chang draws a foul, shooting a three-pointer. That will be against Tyler Lam. So three shots for Chang Hao Chun.
That's a chance to cut it down to single digits. And that was a good job there by Chang selling that call, because I thought there was no contact on the shot itself.
Oh, but he misses the first all-important free throws here. Looking to cut into this lead, Chang Hao Chun.
Misses the second free throw.
They need to make these free throws for them to be able to creep up and come back here in this game with 8:19 to go here in the third. And he makes the third, one out of three for Chang Hao Chun.
So still an 11-point lead here. Here's that 2-3 zone Kaohsiung has stuck with.
Lam, wing, they move the ball around. Josh Boone with an easy hoop underneath.
A strong move there from Josh Boone. And because the defense extended to the perimeter, it was a wide open pass to the baseline.
Sue finding trouble inside. Back to Oliver. Derek Hall looking for a teammate. Sue takes the shot. Back short again for Wesley Su, still struggling here in this game.
And that's going to be a foul on Josh Boone, who immediately admits to the call.
We talked about earlier how good Kaohsiung Truth, or how good they are in rebounding, as we see Josh Boone score underneath.
That was a great entry pass coming from wing.
13-point lead for the Long Lions. Oliver kicks it back out. Oh, nice spin for Chang Hao Chun, and he flips it up and in.
What a move there from Chang, just to be able to elude Josh Boone, who was going for the shot block. So breathing some life into this Kaohsiung Truth arena.
Chang Hao Chun with a highlight play over Josh Boone nonetheless.
Just barely grazing the hand of Josh Boone.
And that trims the lead to 11 points here. Early in the third quarter, Tang. Marcus Elliott looking for Josh Boone inside. They double team him. Elliott penetrates. He puts it up. That's no good for Marcus Elliott.
He had an open Tyler Lamb at the corner. So Elliott deciding to take it strong. Good stop here for the Truth as Hong Kong sets up their 1-2-2 full court pressure once again.
Derek Hall puts it on the floor. Back out to Cedric Oliver. Su open for three.
And you notice how Su hesitated because Josh Boone was about to close out.
Oliver with a fade. That's good for Cedric Oliver.
And again, that high-low play from Derek Hall to Cedric Oliver against the smaller Marcus Elliott.
Lead is back down to single digits here at 39-48. As we have another foul here. Take a look at that fadeaway jumper from Cedric Oliver over Marcus Elliott.
That's actually a very tough shot there. All over the outstretched hands of Elliott and Josh Boone.
Good defense, but better offense for Cedric Oliver right there. Josh Boone. Wesley Su forcing that foul to prevent that easy bucket for Josh Boone.
And another good entry pass there. Wide open in the middle was Josh Boone against that 2-3 zone.
6:38 to go here in the third quarter. Jay Wei entering the ball game now, replacing Chang.
Picker lineup here for the Kaohsiung Truth.
Going small here.
As Wesley Su tries to argue case or plead his case with a referee.
Josh Boone
makes both free throws.
Back up to 11 points is the lead for the Long Lions. Here we go. Inigo looking for Jay Wei for three. In and out.
Sorry, miss there for Jay Wei. A little cold off the bench.
Tyler Lam at the corner. Oh, miscommunication for Tang and Lam. Here's Sue. Oh, looking to take that shot. Oliver, step back. Trying to find Oliver in, or Derek Hall, rather, yep, inside.
But Derek Hall was already in rebounding position.
Again, a missed opportunity for the Truth. Here's Marcus Elliott, short on the three-pointer. Inigo, eluding the pressure from Hong Kong.
Hong Kong getting back on defense. Now they're showing a 2-3 zone.
Inigo, top of the key, three-pointer.
Has not hit a three-point shot in this ball game as Achi Inigo.
Derek Hall from the corner, that's also no good. So the Kaohsiung Truth struggling here to start the third. Ki Lee for three.
Both teams struggling from the outside, so Achi Inigo wisely settles his troops.
Here's Cedric Oliver. Looking for Jay Way at the corner, open briefly. Back out to Oliver, double teamed. Oliver looking for Jay Way, but Josh Boone is right there for the block.
And the defensive presence of Josh Boone, again, bearing fruit here for Coach Edu Torres. Great reaction there.
Great reflexes for Josh Boone. And also great presence of mind for him to stay with the player on offense. As we have another timeout on the floor for Coach Sabatino Chen. With 4:56 to go here in the third quarter, we'll be back for more of your Asean Basketball League action. Back here in Kaohsiung, Taiwan, Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions still up by 11 points here with 4:56 remaining here in the third quarter. Marco, it's been a tough second half so far for the Kaohsiung Truth. How will they recover and keep themselves here in this game?
They have to start out on defense. They have to make stops. Hong Kong themselves have not been able to break this game wide open. Both teams have scored low here in the third quarter, just 7 points for Kaohsiung and 6 points for the Eastern Long Lions. Both teams not able to convert from the outside.
Lam missing that floater. But ball will remain with the Long Lions. 14 seconds on the shot clock.
And you know, hopefully Kaohsiung can run that high-low play a few more times, because they've been successful with that, whether it's for Raymar Jose or Cedric Oliver against their mismatch.
Here's Kinsert, back out to Elliott. This time against Jay Way, gets the screen from Josh Boone. Elliott forcing that one up. Oh. But Lee Key
winning another possession here. Great physical defense from Jay Way against Marcus Elliott.
And Kinsert.
All for not, yep.
Kinsert nailing that corner three-pointer.
That's what we mean when we say the supporting cast of Hong Kong have been almost just as good as their main guns. Lee Key winning that second chance opportunity, resulting in a corner triple for Steven Ginchard.
Steven Ginchard left wide open again at the corner. Now a 14-point lead for Hong Kong. Jay Way missing another three. Here's Marcus Elliott. Ginchard in transition. Key check for him.
Kaohsiung cannot fall in love with that three-point shot or with the outside shot. Hopefully they try to get something inside as another turnover here. Watch out.
And Elliott all the way for the jam.
Nobody there. Back in transition for the Kaohsiung Truth. And don't look now, the lead is up to 16.
Series of moves from Raymar Jose inside, but they kick it back out. Great defense being shown here by the Long Lions. Jose underneath, and he is able to draw a foul.
Smart move there. Elliott. Smart move by Raymar Jose. Knew he had no chance. One-on-one against Josh Boone. And here's that highlight play once again from Marcus Elliott.
Great throwdown right there. We need to see it twice, Marco, on the replay. Marcus Elliott, second throwdown of this game.
One of the most athletic guards we have here in the Asean Basketball League.
As Raymar Jose misses the first free throw, it's now a 16-point lead for the Long Lions.
First point of the ball game for Raymar Jose, so not a very good outing here.
He is back down to 15 with 3:05 to go here in the third. Tyler Lamb. Here's Kinchel, mid-range jumper. No good. Jay Way with a board, but guess who? Lee Key.
Another second chance opportunity, and Tyler Lamb is going to make Kaohsiung pay.
Tyler Lamb left wide open, nailing that three-pointer at the wing. Here's Shin. It's now an 8-point lead for the Long Lions. Biggest of the game so far. Derek Hall puts it on the floor. Kicks it back out to Jay Way for three. Strong for Jay Way. Ginchard.
Shin was wide open at the corner. And Shin forced the foul. Marcus Elliott, as it was a 3-on-2 fast break opportunity for the Long Lions.
They need to stop the bleeding as we see this wide open 3-point bomb earlier from Tyler Lamb.
That is the 14th point of Tyler Lamb. So the big three of Hong Kong, Marcus Elliott with 19, Tyler Lamb with 14, Josh Boone with 12. Remember, in their last game against the Westports Malaysia Dragons, these three players combined for 74 points. 74 of the 115 points of Hong Kong. That's that three-headed monster for you.
Very tough to give those wide open looks to the number one three-point shooting here, or three-point shooting team here in the league. Here's Hall posting up, double team. Derek Hall puts it up and he puts it in. Finally a bucket for the Kaohsiung Truth, and they get a steal here. Jay Way open for three. Short, but here's the Long Lions in transition.
Jay Way forced to give up the duty foul there. It would have been another highlight play for Tyler Lamb. Jay Way has had a bad outing from the three-point land. There's a duty foul. Had to swipe at him a couple of times before the referee made the call.
Missed opportunity again earlier for the Truth after that bucket, but Derek Hall coming up with a steal. But unable to convert. Here's Tyler Lamb now at the free throw line. He drains the first.
Jay Way is just 2 out of 6 from deep.
Long Lions all business here. As Tyler Lamb makes both free throws, lead is now at 19 points.
As Luo checks into the ball game, only his second appearance, played just 1:27 in the first half.
Luo replacing Jay Way as he gets the ball across. Here he is against Tyler Lamb. Shin for three. Oh, that's good for Shin.
And gives a dagger look to Wing, who challenged him on that shot.
Tyler Lamb.
That's a hard foul there from Derek Hall. But again, you see the philosophy of Hong Kong after the basket of Kaohsiung. Immediately a quick inbound, quick outlet pass or forward pass to Tyler Lamb, who attacks the rim and draws the foul on Derek Hall.
That is how you kill a momentum,
yep.
A potential momentum swing for a team.
No opportunity to take a break here for the Kaohsiung Truth as Hong Kong looks to score every time.
16-point lead for the Long Lions. 1 minute, 21 seconds to go as Tyler Lam extends that lead to 17.
And they have outscored the Kaohsiung Truth 18 to 13 here in the third quarter. Make that 19 to 13.
Lead is back up to 18. Here's Luo dealing with the Hong Kong pressure. And he draws a foul. That would be against Chan Siu Wing.
That's one of the things about that Hong Kong backcourt, whether it's Wing or Lee Key, very tough backcourt. And you add them together with Marcus Elliott and Tyler Lam, very tough and athletic backcourt. That has been one of the critical factors to their success here in the ABL.
But Hong Kong is now in the penalty, which means two free throws for Luo. He misses the first. Again, very crucial misses from the free throw line for the Kaohsiung Truth.
Kaohsiung shooting 4 out of 11. So just not making any headway from the free throw stripe.
Approaching a minute remaining here in the third. And an offensive foul is called.
Legal screen set there.
That will be against Woo Chuk Pan. Woo Chuk Pan, just a hard screen, a moving screen rather.
I don't know about that. With the way the physicality has gone here in the ball game.
And another turnover for the Truth. Here's Wing in transition. Ginchard back out to Lam for three. Short. Luo on the fast break play, and Luo takes it all the way to the hoop.
Oh, and a steal here from Shin.
Shin getting into the passing lane, forcing that steal. Derek Hall scores another bucket.
4-0 run here for the Kaohsiung Truth. 25 seconds left, and the lead is down to 14.
Back-to-back fast break buckets for the Kaohsiung Truth. They now trail 49-63 with 25.6 seconds remaining here in the third quarter.
And Luo has been the catalyst here with less than a minute to go here in the third quarter.
One shot, all right? So we'll play. We're open. And you set in the pit. Okay? So that means Marcus, Ewing, Kay, and Tyler. All right? We'll just, hey, we gotta make sure every time we mount, they're there, okay? That shit happened 3 or 4 times. So right now, you inbound, cross to catch the ball, and whenever we attack, skip. Hey, there will be one more defensive effort, okay? Like 3-4 more seconds. So just get back, all right? Yeah, come on, yeah. Yeah, man. Calm down.
Back here in the Asean Basketball League, Coach Edu Torres taking every second of that timeout, not taking granted of anything here this game.
And he even inserts Marcus Elliott back into the ball game for the final possession of the third quarter. That's how important this possession is for him.
They're still up by 14 points, 63 to 49, 14 seconds. Elliott, isolation play against Luo. Oh, nice crossover, eluding Luo. Kicks it back out, Leakey for three, that's good! What a way to end the third quarter here.
That's just a great play call off a timeout, and that possession controlled entirely by Marcus Elliott.
And that puts them back up by 17 points. Right now, Marco, 66 to 49. As we end the third quarter here, we'll be back for the fourth quarter action here in the ASEAN Basketball League.
Give me the...
right back, all right?
We are coming to you live here from Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School here in Kaohsiung, Taiwan, for another offering of your Asean Basketball League. And right now, the home team, the Kaohsiung Truth, are down 66-49 against the number one team in the league, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. Good evening once again, everyone. My name is Martin Aver, working alongside Marco Benitez here. Marco, the Kaohsiung Truth were able to mount a mini run towards the end of the third quarter, but the Long Lions, the well-disciplined team that they are, were able to come up with a play that extended the lead back to 17 points.
And that's the reason why I wanted they're the number one team here in the ABL. Whenever they need a basket, their execution is right on the mark, as we saw off of that timeout, that three-point shot. And again, here off a miss within 5 seconds, basket on the other end by Steven Ginchard. Hong Kong loves to push and capitalize on the Kaohsiung's mistakes, and the lead is back up to 19.
Hong Kong starting with a fast pace here in the fourth as they force another turnover here.
And you know, very reminiscent of their meeting in that last February 22. They also started out that fourth quarter really strong. 7-0 run for Hong Kong to start out that fourth quarter.
Here's Lee. Oh, nice steal from Shin. Another steal for him. And he lays it up and in.
Hong Kong right back here in transition.
Here's Wing. Again, that momentum stopper, but that time unable to finish it.
Yep, Marcos Elliott not ready for the pass. Here's that steal coming from Shin. Decides to take it all the way. Finishes with the left. As Coach Edu Torres sends Josh Boone back into the fray.
Shin with three steals here in the game so far. But the lead is still 17 points. Jose. Luo. Oliver puts it on the floor. Shin, another three. That rims out for Shin.
And Josh Boone makes sure.
Here's Elliott. Oh, and another swipe for Shin. Here's Luo in transition. Fakes. Oh, and a nice effort and the block for Wing.
Should have gone up strong on the first attempt.
The Truth unable to convert. Here's Elliott. Draws a foul. That will be against Raymar Jose.
Referee is finally making the call after a series of physical play. Here's that block by Wing. Luo probably should have gone up or made a drop pass to Derek Hall.
Chan Siu Wing preventing the easy basket here for the Truth as Marcus Elliott misses the first. Back and forth action so far to start off the fourth quarter.
Marcus Elliott with 22 points, 7 rebounds, 4 of 7 from the three-point line.
Just another day in the office for Marcus Elliott, as you guys can see, Coach Edu Torres on your screens. Doing a great job here in this game. They're up by 17 points.
Marcus Elliott averaged about 24 points, 6.9 rebounds. Right now he's up to 20 points and 5 rebounds, 2 assists.
And he ranks number one in both categories here in the ASEAN Basketball League. Talking about, of course, the points and the assists for Marcus Elliott. Jay Wei checks back in for the Truth, replacing Jose. Here's that press one more time for the Long Lions. Oliver kicks it back out. Sue, corner three. Still no good for Wesley Sue. Oh, great effort for Cedric Oliver. And Derek Hall draws a foul underneath.
And Wesley Su has had an off night here. After that first three-point shot in the first quarter at the top of the key, has not been able to convert. That was the most open he's been all evening long.
Wesley Su has been struggling in the past few games. Cedric Oliver forcing that one up.
Asking for the foul there, but again, no time to argue here for Kaohsiung, as Hong Kong is back in their front court.
Here's Josh Boone inside. That's no good. Oh, Cedric Oliver with a quick hands. Tapping that entry pass. Sue transition three. Finally good for Wesley Sue.
Second three-pointer of the ball game for Wesley Sue.
Lead is down to 15 points. 69-54. Here comes the Long Lions. Josh Boone inside. Back to wing. Kicks it back out to Elia. Top of the key. Three. That's good. And he answers the three-pointer.
And Hong Kong has had an answer for every run or every punch that Kaohsiung has thrown so far.
Here, Su takes it in off the glass. And Wesley Su scores another bucket for the truth.
Gotta make some stops on the other end, though, if you're Kaohsiung.
Back-to-back baskets again for Wesley Su. Here, Skinchard puts it on the floor and draws a foul.
Useless foul there for Luo. If you're Kaohsiung, you want to probably trim this down to less than 10 or 12 points going into the last 5 minutes of the ball game. Give yourselves a shot to make a final push as we see those last 5 points coming from Wesley Su.
They're still playing catch-up here. Down by 16 points, as you guys can see. Wesley Su now with 7 points in the ball game. 13 seconds on the shot clock for the Long Lions. Elliott gets the screen from Boone. Lee. Back out to Elliott, unable to handle the pass. The shot clock will expire.
And that is going to be the sixth turnover for Marcus Elliott. So another chance here for the truth to execute and get a basket. Chop it down to 14, even 13-point deficit.
We'll see if the truth can take advantage of this. Turnover. Oliver back out to Sue for three. In and out. Oh, Oliver right there for the putback.
14-point deficit here. 6:09. Still a lot of time here if you're Kaohsiung. Good pressure comes from Jay Wei.
Elliott goes to Tyler Lam. Back to Elliott. Forcing it on Jay Wei. Lee Key for three. No good. Here comes the truth. Inigo seeing Jay Wei wide open in transition, plus the foul
and
for Jay Wei.
What a forward pass there from Achi Inigo from three-quarter court all the way to Jay Wei at the baseline.
Here's that play one more time. Inigo with a vision to Jay Wei, and he finishes for the truth. As we go to another timeout on the floor, the lead is down to 12 for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. Back here in this game between the Kaohsiung Truth and the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, a series of plays that enabled the Truth to climb here in this game, only down by 12 points right now, Marco.
And you know, aside from those baskets on the offensive end, they're doing it on defense. And you know, if you're the Kaohsiung Truth, the name of the game here is you make everybody else, aside from Marcus Elliott, Tyler Lamb and Josh Boone, beat you. So you make Lau Tzu Lai, Lee Key, even Steven Ginchard and Chang Shu Wing, make them beat you. And you deny or you force the ball out of the hands of Marcus Elliott, Josh Boone, and Tyler Lamb.
Jay Wei completing that three-point play. Here's Elliott. Oh, left wide open for the three. Too strong. He doesn't get the bounce.
And that's not a high percentage shot if you're Marcus Elliott. So that's a good stop here if you're Kaohsiung. Chance to cut it down even further.
Oliver Inigo hesitated on the three. Su, no good. Oh, nice stop from Oliver. And nice behind the back pass. That leads to the bucket for Cedric Oliver.
And the Kaohsiung Truth are pumped up here. What a behind the back pass from Jay Wei.
Jay Wei just getting fancy here. First the top from Cedric Oliver, and Jay Wei going behind the back to Cedric Oliver for the bucket.
Rewarding his big man for that tap to win them the extra possession.
But they need to make these free throws, and he does. Lead is down to 8 points here with 5:14 to go here in this game. Elliott. Inigo putting the pressure on Marcus Elliott. Lam forces that three. Short. Josh Boone right there for the putback.
And the value of having a Josh Boone tip it to himself. But again, you see the defense of Kaohsiung trying to challenge every shot, trying to force the ball out of the hands of Marcus Elliott.
They swing the ball around. Jay Wei back to Derek Hall. Corner three. That's short.
That's okay. He's your 50% three-point shooter. One of the few attempts he's taken so far. Marcus Elliott settles down the troops.
The Truth feeling a sense of urgency right now. Osas, they force another steal and another turnover. Here's Jay Wei in transition. Inigo back to Hall. And Derek Hall draws a foul.
Good job on the part of Derek Hall running in transition. And Achi Inigo, the point guard in him, rewarding the big man for running the floor.
Nice behind the back bounce pass to a running Derek Hall right there, able to draw a foul against Lau Tzu Lai.
Derek Hall so far perfect from the free throw stripe in this game, 2 out of 2.
But he misses the first. Another chance for him to cut this lead to single digits.
And
he
misses both.
Strange for Derek Hall.
Yep.
Usually a good free throw shooter. Elliott against Inigo once more. Down to 4 minutes to play here in the fourth. Tzu Lai. Back out to Leakey for three. Too strong. Lam tracks down the board. And he flips it up and in.
Got a box out. Possession doesn't stop unless you corral the rebound. They made a good effort defending the perimeter, but not able to get the stop. Not able to get the defensive rebound.
Lead is back up to 12 points for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, but Derek Hall has something to say about that.
And they're going to have to put a lot more pressure here. 3 minutes and 20 seconds remaining.
Here comes Hong Kong once again. Lam back to Elliott on the other side.
And you know, if I'm Kaohsiung, I'm giving that outside shot to Lau Tzu Lai.
And he takes the shot. That's no good. Inigo again pushing the ball on the floor. Cedric Oliver. Ooh, a sorry miss. Derek Hall tried to tip that back in. Elliott forcing it. And forcing a foul against Wesley Su.
And Derek Hall always in control, controlling the pace there. He was looking for the open man. Tried to bait the defense to come to him so that he could throw a lob to Josh Boone.
Marcus Elliott doing the facilitating here for the Long Lions as we have another timeout here for the Truth. Back to a 10-point lead for the Long Lions as we wind down the fourth quarter here in this game.
Hit shots. You guys are getting good shots. Hit and hit the open shots. On defense, guys. can't wait till the last 2 minutes to play defense like that, okay? You got to do it the whole game. Now keep it going.
Yo.
They're playing harder than them. Get the rebounds. They're taking bad shots. Long rebound. Stay away, Adji. Long rebound. Okay? And get it and run. Guys, just because they score, get it out. Go. Get into it from there. Okay? Spacing, move it, get the extra pass, get the shot. Let's go. Keep going hard. We got another timeout. We got guys ready. Okay? Let's go. Defense on three. One, two, three.
You guys just heard head coach Sabatino Chen barking last-minute instructions here in this game. And they're not out of it, Marco.
Yep.
They're not out of it. Lots of time here. 2:50 remaining. It's only a 10-point lead.
Coach Sabatino Chen putting a lot of emphasis on defense because that is where they're going to have to make their headway. They're going to have to try to pressure the ball handler of Hong Kong, try to force them to speed up the tempo so that they can force some turnovers or make them take hurried shots. But the most important thing as well is they're going to have to get that defensive rebound. Otherwise, Hong Kong is just going to get second chance opportunities.
And their defense here in the fourth quarter has been on point.
Yep. And, you know, it's not yet the point for Kaohsiung where they have to take hurried three-point shots. They can still try to get some quick baskets inside the paint, quick baskets in transition. But this offensive rebound for Hong Kong definitely going to hurt.
Ginter tracking that ball down. Here's Josh Boone putting it on the floor. Back out to Ginter, wide open for three. That's good for Steven Ginter.
And that is big. Could be the backbreaker here for the Truth.
It's now a 14-point lead once again.
They're going to try to post Cedric Oliver.
Oh, great closeout by Tyler Lamb. And Tyler Lamb comes up with it.
Pass was too early there for Wesley Su as Oliver was still trying to box out or trying to fight for position inside the paint. Here's that three-point shot. And, you know, what you love about Steven Ginter, whenever he does that catch and shoot, he's always square to the basket. Gets a lot of elevation on that jump shot.
Great off-the-ball movement as well for Steven Ginter. Finding himself wide open for that three-pointer.
Coach Edu Torres sending Marcus Elliott to the bench for this possession.
Last 2 minutes off the game, Josh Boone flips it up and he puts it in.
Could be the nail in the coffin right there. Lead is back up to 16.
Here's Jose against Lee. They badly need a basket here in Nigo against Tyler Lamb. Difficult matchup for him. Inigo back inside to Derek Hall. And another three-point play opportunity for the big man.
That was a good roll there from Derek Hall. Achi Inigo was looking for it the moment he drew the double team. That's a great pocket pass there from the former FEU point guard.
Derek Hall has a chance to cut this lead to 13 points. And he does. 1:45 remaining here in the game.
Now they're going to have to put up some full court pressure here. Try to get some steals.
Here's Lam. Let's see what the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lines will do. Wing. Mid-range J is no good, but Josh Boone again for the tip-in.
Nobody boxing out Josh Boone. Easy 2 points.
Inigo having trouble with the ball right there. Missing the shot. Shin also missing the putback. Back to Shin. Jose eludes Lam.
Oh, that's going to be an offensive goaltending violation.
That ball was about to go in.
Yep.
For Raymar Jose. Nonetheless, an offensive interference called on the Truth. Here's Tyler Lam approaching the last minute mark here.
Kaohsiung has got to put some pressure on the ball handler.
8 seconds on the shot clock. Tyler Lam, series of moves, and Josh Boone again with a reverse.
And that's too easy, allowing Tyler Lam to penetrate your 2-3 zone. And then the bounce pass to Josh Boone for the reverse.
15-point lead for the Long Lions on their way to their eighth straight victory here in Kaohsiung, Taiwan.
And Kaohsiung is going to drop to 5-11. Currently at the fifth spot.
After this game, they cannot afford to lose if they want to take that fourth and final spot.
Yep.
Tyler Lam wide open for three. And we're just waiting for the final score here.
Tyler Lam going to go up to 20 points in this ball game. So the big three of Hong Kong, Marcos Elliot with 25, Tyler Lam with 20, Josh Boone with 18 points and 13 rebounds. So another big performance for the three-headed monster of the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions.
Shin had a nice game himself. Sorry about the truth. As we are down to the last 3.1 seconds remaining here. The Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions still number one here. Marco scoring their eighth straight victory over the Kaohsiung Truth. 89-75 is our final score. Great effort for both teams, but the Long Lions were just too good, just too strong again for the Truth.
And you know, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions are going to sweep the season series between these two squads 4-0. And the Kaohsiung Truth held tough when in the first quarter, especially when they were hitting the three-point shots. But beginning the second quarter, when the three-point shot deserted them, Hong Kong started to pull away. They were up big going to the halftime. I believe it was double digits. And then in the third quarter, Kaohsiung tried to make some headway. But that fourth quarter, even though they were able to cut it down to single digits, Hong Kong with enough poise, enough discipline, able to execute, force Kaohsiung to some forced and hurried shots, and then execute on the offensive end to pull away with the win.
Valiant effort for the home team, the Kaohsiung Truth, but it was the visitors, again, the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, scoring this victory on the home floor of the Truth, 89-75. Marcus Elliott coming up big for them, as usual, Marco, with 25 points. Josh Boone also adding 20 points and 13 boards, in his fourth double-double here in the Asean Basketball League. All games he's played, he's had a double-double so far.
He has been the monster for the Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions. And let's see if they continue their run. He could be the key or the big turning point. His acquisition for Hong Kong could be the turning point that takes them all the way to the finals and secures for them their first ASEAN Basketball Championship.
But of course, for the Truth, they still have a chance at the fourth spot, Marco. After this, what are their games again?
They're going to be playing the Singapore Slingers, two games against the Westports Malaysia Dragons, and then close out their elimination round against Alab Pilipinas.
So that is the situation for the Kaohsiung Truth. But again, you see the final score of this game. Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions winning by 14 points over the home team, the Kaohsiung Truth, again sweeping the season series over the Truth 4-0. Final score 89-75. Great game we witness here. Valiant effort again for the Kaohsiung Truth. As we thank you so much here for tuning in once again here in the ASEAN Basketball League. My name is Martin Abier, alongside Marco Benitez, and we are out.